Okay guys, welcome back to Soul Calibur 6, welcome back to Avalanche Multimedia Channel. I am Tony, and we'll get right back into where we left off last time. We've come started the prologue of story mode, and we completed the Libra of Soul mission. Our next mission is Chapter 1, which is the Blades of Fate. And our character, after creation, got to level 4. So I hope you enjoy my sound effects. I tried to do different interpretation voices on the last one, and I also tried to do the same on this one. So I hope you like my interpretation of audio, as there is no audio to the characters, so I've kind of tried to put my own spin on it. So, without further ado, I opened my eyes in a truly impossible sight. I was floating in a vast space. The ground was nowhere to be seen, and the sky stretched onto its infinity. Ruined chunks of masonry floated nearby, a broken pillar from a temple, a half-collapsed house, and a fall of tower structures of every shape and size from every corner of the globe. At the center of it was an enormous whirlpool of light. I watched as the colossal building was drawn into its bricks, ripping from their mortar and accelerating into a brilliant glow. A piece of rubble made contact and disappeared into the utter silence. The light captivated me with its beauty, but at the same time, it filled my heart with dread. Little by little, that terrible light was drawing me in the struggle. As I might, I could not break free of its inexorable grasp. Slowly, ever slowly, the distance between us shrank. Maybe it was destined for my soul to become entwined with its astral chaos. But I will not submit to destiny and allow myself to be consumed by the bright harbinger of death. I need strength, the strength to defy my fate. The light drew me in when suddenly two swords appeared before me. As I reached out to grasp the floating blades, a voice broke the silence. Those who dare strength must make a choice. If you value freedom and wish for power to pursue your own path, choose the golden sword. If you honor the virtues of harmony and reason, and wish for the power to bring order to the chaotic world, choose the Azure Sword. So now we have a choice. Reach for the golden sword, or reach for the Azure Sword. And I'm gonna go for the Azure Sword. I grasped the Azure Sword and felt a wave of peace wash over me. My mind tranquil, my senses sharp, I raised the blade high, then struck a swift blow at the swirling light.
Your soul resonates with the light.
Hey, you okay? You ought to be careful swinging your weapon around like that by yourself. Have you maybe a few too many drinks? Barely conscious, I couldn't tell if the nightmare had ended. A shadow of what looked like an enemy wavered in front of me. One that seemed robust, strong, armed, I readied my weapons. My only escape from his nightmare was to fight. Whoa, easy there. I'm not looking for a fight. Well, looks like I got no choice. You back to your senses? It wasn't a nightmare. I'd been fighting for real when I came to a friendly yet somewhat heroic looking man was standing before me. My name's Maxie. What do you go by? I told Maxie my name. Sir Clay! Nice name. Don't worry, I ain't gonna steal all your possessions or anything. You know, you got skills, but an apology for attacking me out of nowhere. How about listening to what I gotta say? It's nothing bad, just a job offer. According to Maxie, the residents of a nearby village suddenly vanished one day. At the same time, a mysterious hole formed nearby, from which strange creatures had started to emerge. The village head believed it was these creatures who had attacked the villagers and ordered they may be found and exterminated. I know I'm having myself, so I agreed to help, but they wanted to take care of the hole, as well as the creatures. Right, when I was thinking I needed some help, I ran into you, the ward juicier than the rare snake. How about a 50-50 split sound? The mysterious hole sounded a lot like an asphalt fissure. When I asked Maxie where it was, he pointed towards the direction I was heading. I decided to accept his offer. Alright then, let's do this, partner. With a self-assured grin, he extended his hand in the spirit of solidarity. I grasped it firmly. As someone who had traveled the world, Maxie had a lot of stories to tell about Jimmy. All I hear nowadays is crazy talk. To the west of the continent, some lord suddenly went nuts. In another town, there's a massacre that wiped out the entire population, but nobody knows who or what caused it. Even when we were attacked by a bunch of creeps, the red had eyes. Maxie was the captain of a pirate crew who was venturing around the globe, yet he didn't speak in an aggressive or threatening tone. You know, I forgot to ask, what's giving you a travel bug, Sir Gawain? We're saying too much. I mentioned there was something I needed to take care of at the Astral Fissure, created by the Evil Seed. Never heard of it. Some of my crew might know something, though. I'll ask around. Man, I'm going to turn in for the day. See you bright and early tomorrow. Huh? I woke up with a splitting hearing, the remnants of a nightmare flickering in my mind. What's up? You were calling out in your sleep. Here's a drink. Drink up. I thanked Maxie and told him with nothing my headache subsided, but I wasn't going to be getting any more sleep. Suddenly I heard a voice behind me. When I turned, there was a young man standing with a smile on his face. He gave us a small nod. Greetings, my assumed friend. You also heavy furious of voice on a mission to hunt monsters? Yeah, we are. You too? Yes, my name is Aran. I heard there was others who accepted the mission. So I thought I would introduce myself. I see, I'm Maxie. This is my partner, Sir Gawain. I have a suggestion, how about we join forces? While I signed off for this mission, my intent was only to save those in trouble. I have no problem with splitting the wolf with you. Sounds like a plan. But I'm gonna have to rest, I'm gonna have to test your skills first. You game? Yes, of course. Let's just begin. You win! I must say your aggressive style is very impressive. You're not so bad yourself. Where'd you pick up those staff skills? At Ling Ching Su, alongside my brother. To be honest, I thought I'd fare better with me against you. Nah, you did good. I feel like it should be my asking you to join my forces. You're with me, right, Sir Gawain? Let me settle. Around your number team. Welcome aboard. Thank you. As a sign of our new friendship, how about one of the Ling Cheng Ju's famous cakes? No one should fight on an empty stomach. Deal. Deal me in. Come on, Sigrain, dig in. Stop right there! What are you doing here? We qualify as much over this area ahead. Those without permission, Pupsy, will be turned to gray.
Qualifiers? I've heard the name of some rumors going around recently, but something about saving humanity?
Quit battling and get out of here already.
We're only here to hunt monsters. If you share the same mission, it would benefit us all to work together.
You think I was born yesterday? You're trying to get to the Astral Fissure. That's Lord Aswell's. And I'll be damned if you get in his way.
An Astral Fissure? Isn't that the thing you were talking about, Sigrain?
I knew it! Danielle, these ruffians are trying to disrupt Lord Aswell's plans. We should kill them before he arrives.
A Razor Man raised his weapon.
Hold it, Valtro.
He would hate for us to fight other people. The man let out a beach sigh, and when his blade pointed at us, continue to talk.
We don't want any trouble. Just leave. It's full for our sakes, if you get me.
It looks like they're not budging.
Huh. That just means we can skip to the good bit.
Quit whittering. I vouch for all slay all those who stand in Lord Aswell's way.
I think it's better if we stand down, Valtro. Let's go.
Damn you to hell.
Next time we meet, you want us to keep my blade.
Going by what they said, it will seem Lord Aswell's hasn't arrived.
Let's head over before things start to get messy. The power surging from the deep fissure oppressed the entire area, swallowing up even the surrounding sound.
That is a hole they were talking about? Give me a break. That ain't just any hole.
How troubling. It seems beyond our ability to handle.
Hey, partner. Is that what you were looking for?
I nodded. Maxi shook his head in resignation.
Sounds like the rumors about monsters appearing were true.
With a burst of light, a warrior appeared from the asphalt fissure. It let out an earth-shaking roar as it readied its weapon.
Rawr! Rawr!
Great, I knew this was not going to be easy.
Rawr!
The photo warrior burst into light that soon faded.
We down? Geez, what the hell? What was that all about?
The creature appeared to be human, but it left no trace of its existence. As though it was a phantom.
I'm pretty sure the marks on the body count as traces, okay? What about this hole?
Staring into the seeming internal blackness, I thrust both my hands into the fissure.
Hey, what are you doing?
The hole, it just vanished.
What the hell did you do?
I told Maxi to ram everything. After a long pause, Maxi gave a slight nod.
Okay, well, I got no reason to doubt you after what I just saw.
Agreed. I've seen some bizarre things in my life, but nothing like that. How are you feeling?
The mission's done, so you may as well rest up here while I check to see if the road's safe.
I'll go replenish our water supplies at Grave. Some sweeps should help perk you up. Help yourself.
Your soul surges in your body.
What? The asshole fish is gone? I think I spy a culprit. What happened here?
I do not know, Master. However, something feels off.
It may be something in their possession. We must deal with this at once.
You stay back.
As the man in black readied his weapon, a chill ran down my spine as I felt a rush of bloodlust.
I do not know what you are, but I know you possess unnatural power. Show it to me if you dare.
Not bad. The man raised his hands and pulled away his weapon, causing a stir amongst his allies.
Are you certain?
It's really wise not to let an outsider get away.
I have obtained all the information I need.
Hey, what's going on?
Fall back.
Sir?
Sir?
Maxie ran over and stared hard at me before speaking.
You okay? What was that deal? What was the weird getup?
A rabbit turned and he also realized something was wrong.
I found some water. Did something happen while I was gone?
Yeah, the queen was attacked by some freaky group.
A freaky group like rabbits?
It didn't look like rabbits. Well, everyone's safe, at least. I think our way ahead's safe, but we should stay alert Those freaks may come back.
Your soul surges in your body.
And the 12 feet, the astral fishes beckon, and that brings us to the end of chapter 1, and we're on to chapter 2 next time. So join us for part 5 of Soul Calibur 6. On our story conquest next time of Avalanche Multimedia. I have been your host, Tony. Thank you for watching Avalanche Multimedia. And it's a goodbye for me for now.